I don't think the outfits in the 70s were as bad as you would expect. Mine were no worse than anyone else's.
So, an outfit that traumatized me might have been a little brown flowered one that choked me, and I had a perm, so I looked a little muffiny.
Now this is my fault. I cut my bangs that morning. I had long hair. I cut my bangs way up to here. Mom was just mortified because it was school picture morning. Her barber, he's like, I don't know what to do with this hair. So he just thought, what do we do with spikes? We perm them. Permed, totally tight fro, no long hair, no bangs, and a gigantic bow.
I don't really have any outfits that traumatized me. I do have a haircut, the one in Brazil where they chopped my bangs to here, and then I had my natural frizz, and so it was just like little straight bangs, frizz everywhere, and then awkward braces, and then my face just, I hadn't grown into my face, so like it was really disproportionate. It was kind of like a Picasso. It was like an eyeball here and an eyeball here, and it was just, it got really bad. But I don't know that you necessarily traumatized me with any outfits. I remember all those cute outfits I got that one time with all the dresses with bells in them and whatnot. That was fun.
I could have been prevented from wearing the red Sally Jesse Raphael glasses for that time in middle school or high school.
Well, at night, Dan and I would run into our twin beds and scream, Mom's coming! And then crash into our beds. But before we started playing piano and organ, our pillows being the piano and the organ, you would come in, if it was Saturday night, bath night, question mark, why would there only be one bath night a week? Then you would warm our sheets up with the hairdryer. Then you would sing, God Will Take Care of You. And I loved it.
A bedtime memory would be singing, God will take care of you through every day and all the way. And the matching bedspreads that she made for us are quilts. That was a cozy memory.
I would say Mom singing, God Will Take Care of You. Because it's a memory that's held with me to the point where I sing it to my girls at night. And it's just a song that comforts me. You know, even when I sing it to my girls, it still comforts me, I'm sure, the way I felt when I was a child.
Well, I'll avoid saying God will take care of you because I feel like everyone would pick that song. But I do remember from the very earliest is Mommy and a Danny go, bye-bye, Mommy and a Danny go. Bye-bye, Mama and Danny go. Bye-bye. And I don't know how it ends. But I'm sure you sang that to me a lot when you were driving me around town.
Probably when you would say that I have a rat's nest. That one was probably... You probably said that too many times. And I don't think it was very justified, Mom. Hurts.
Definitely could have dialed back the zooming the house going room to room.
I'm only one person. I'm only one person.
Fresh and moist. They get me every time.
It was these moments of either complete, utter, just, I've had enough. But it was also times where she would chitter when she just looked at her kids with just pure joy and excitement of just, oh, they're my children and I love them. And she would just chitter like a chipmunk and be like,
I don't know that I ever really had a nickname like Molly Muffinhead or anything like that. I think that I was just Danny, I guess.
Well, that would be Earthquake. Earthquake or Rachel Dew. Earthquake, if you just hear that and you don't understand why I had that nickname, it just sounds horrible. It sounds just like I'm this
scampers kid marching through, or just taking things out, just left and right.
But no, Earthquake came, so I was told, from a kid's, it's either food, cereal, Charmkins, or a toy, that I couldn't say the word Charmkins, and I'd watch this commercial every day. It was like, Charmkins, Charmkins, la 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 la, Charmkins, but I couldn't say that. I said, Urkay. An Urke sounds like earthquake, so I got the nickname Earthquake.
Nicknames would be Molly Muffinhead, Katrinka, Ravener Mushroom, Mother Hen, Mocker, Big Mouth, Sarah Beth, Sarah B, Natural Leader, which means you're just a big jerk and you don't keep your opinions to yourself.
Nicknames would probably be Beck or Reebok or Dancer or Rachel, whoever your name is.
I would say that Mom has shown me compassion. She has always, like the moment she hears anybody with any type of news, any type of pain, whether it's small or great, Mom would just pray for them. She would be very concerned, see what she could do. I mean, she was a youth pastor's wife, and so being in the church, she was always there to, you know, listen to people and pray for them. I would say what's also really cool about that is you could be really, really busy, and I get this way. I get so busy with work and so busy with kids that I don't stop to see, oh, there's somebody's car broken down, and or, you know, they're on the side of the road. We should see if they need help, or how can we pray for them? And Mom always did that. It was just, she could focus on those needs without the busyness of her life, you know, ahead of it. So that was really cool.
Mom treated everybody that she met with like an open slate, and was able to take them for who they were and meet them where they were at. And certainly my job is to do that with hundreds, if not thousands, of people over the years. And so I'm sure that's something I learned from Mom, is the ability to just take everybody as a blank slate and try to deal with them without judgment and without a loaded back history, but just, you know, for my own impression of who somebody is and whether I want them in my life or whether I can be in theirs.
Things that she's taught me is to be kind to everyone, to get to know people, to believe in God fully, and read the Bible and do devotions. She's very good with people and has taught me to learn people's birthdays and remember them. She is just always kind and great people person. So it's always made me just a little bit more confident when I'm around her, because I know that she can definitely strike up a conversation. I am who I am because of her. I am a sweet little bee.
You know what I love most about you, Mom, is that, you know, your heart is just, it's always for the Lord. It's just, that's your top priority. And that's the thing that you want us to value the most in life, is have a real vibrant relationship with Him and know Him personally and worship Him and tell others about Him. And you're not afraid to pray in tough situations. You're always there for me. I know that you always, always are there for me. And you love to make sure that your kids are comfortable and safe and happy.
Happy Mother's Day from Earthquake.
Happy Mother's Day from Danny.
Happy Mother's Day, Mom. I love you. From Muff.
Happy Mother's Day from Becky. I love you, Mom.